All right, so I was just checking in on flights in and out of PDX. Saw a few delays, but nothing major yet. And if you're in Portland for the Thanksgiving holiday, this might actually be one of the best places to be.
I think it will be. It may be a little windy, but we'll have some sunshine. It's going to be a pretty nice day. But, of course, that forecast can change over the next couple of days.
Yes, which is why we want to stay tuned to Portland's most accurate forecast. Mm-hmm. We've got some stuff happening in the mountains here, Joseph.
Oh, for sure, yeah. And as we head through the overnight, it's going to pick on up, and Monday is going to be the real start of that snow piling up for the mountains. You can see with our Mount Hood Meadows here that little gasp of light that we have left. Temperatures at freezing, no snow coming down yet, but as that moisture starts to roll on in heading into tonight, and for your Monday, we'll start to see that snowfall for the past levels. It's already starting to get cold out there, so we'll continue to watch that. Now, the system that's going to really bring in the activity that we're expecting Tuesday is going to be developing right up here and then eventually moving down to the south, and that tracking is still up in the air. But notice we still have some isolated showers passing through up towards Vancouver Island, maybe even a little bit of lightning there too, but we are staying away from that rain at this hour. We had a little bit early this morning, most of us underneath a tenth of an inch, so it really wasn't much. And then for the most part this afternoon we had some sun breaks, even a little peak of blue sky and a nice sunset for a while too. All right, I'll take you to the Futurecast right away. Notice that through our Monday, we get this little break right here in the valley. That's possible. So although I have rain showers in the forecast from the morning all the way to the evening and at night, I do expect us to have these moments where we'll have this rain shadow set up. We won't see much there. But the snowfall, that's going to be coming down, especially for the morning hours through the passes. If you're traveling tomorrow already, you think about getting out of town and you need to go through 26, it's going to be snowy. As early as tomorrow morning at 7 a.m. So get that prepared. That goes for Meacham Pass if you're heading east on 84 down towards areas like Baker City. If you're traveling south on Interstate 5, though, still should be warm enough to just see the rain. So we're really just concerned about the Cascade Range at that point of time. We start getting into Tuesday, though. Notice that the front edge of this system's on the way. And that's going to bring in the heavy rain, the wind, and also the snowfall, maybe even some icy conditions to the south for that route towards California. But we still have the snowfall there as of Tuesday morning. It will pick up late Tuesday night as this system gets closer. That's that area of low pressure. And when these lines get a little bit tighter, the wind is going to become a little more mighty. And so as we get into Tuesday night, that's going to be probably the strongest of this activity. That's where the heaviest of the snow will likely become for that south and central section of Oregon. Also pulling in this cold air at the same time. So this is what we're watching as we go through the next couple of days, because originally this area of low pressure was forecasted to be a little bit further to the south. And the further north it ends up going, the greater threat that we might see a little bit of snowfall for the valley floor in the south section, maybe towards Eugene as we head into Tuesday night. So that tracking is very important. We'll continue to have updates over the next couple of days. Notice it does pass off to the east. We'll keep some snowfall for the high desert. Cold and breezy weather as we head into Thursday, but it should dry up at that point of time. Notice that the snow levels take a big tumble as we go into Thursday and Friday. How about that snowfall? Well, as we see that increase to the Cascades there, picking up to maybe about a foot of snow by the time we wrap up our Wednesday. And of course, that's just one weather model. Notice that it's trying to push some snowfall down towards Eugene, and that's the threat that we'll have to continue to watch. But again, we're not off the hook here in Portland. We can see that change significantly. 7-day forecast, 40 degrees on Thanksgiving, Friday 38, cold, 28 Thursday morning, 25 Friday morning.
Yeah, those overnights down in the 20s, that's a little chillier than what we've seen lately.
Yes, that's winter jacket weather. But we're going to get some good snowfall for the mountains, get the skis, snowboards, all that stuff ready.
Yeah, exciting stuff. Thanks, Joseph.